Thank you. You may have noticed, but I'm not Irv. I am not Dr. Wagner. My name is Dr. Zachary Daniels, and just due to extenuating circumstances for the past couple weeks, this orchestra, this fine orchestra of lovely musicians, has been subject to my whim. No, they have been working with me, and we have been working really hard to put together an awesome night of new music for you. And I think it's also probably one of my favorite things, but also I'm biased because I'm a young artist, and the name of this is a Young Artist Concert. So I naturally think that this is a really cool opportunity. And one part of young artistry that sometimes gets ignored is that sometimes we don't always see the work that goes into it. Oftentimes we think of it as a pianist spending a long time in the practice room, a violinist working to death on their violin on that one solo they just can't nail. But we also have a couple of other features tonight, including a student conductor, including a new piece of music that has never been heard before until tonight. And I think that really just showcases really the entire wheelhouse of what it means to be a young artist. And I just want to thank you all for being here, and I want to also thank this lovely orchestra for putting in all the hard work that they have, and also just to tout, we've got some awesome soloists for you later. So without further ado, I do want to talk a little bit about the next piece on the program, kind of the first big piece, Periapsis. It's something that I wrote. I guess I'm the composer and conductor for this one. So this piece, I'm a little bit of a geek, and I like spaceflight, orbital mechanics, astronomy, things like that. And this piece was actually inspired very much directly by all of the incredible private spaceflight companies that are out there, just pushing us further into the stars. And for those that are unaware of what periapsis is, I've actually included the exact Merriam-Webster definition in your program so that you can learn a little bit more about it. But you're going to hear a lot of energy from the strings in particular. And trust me, how many times do I use energy in each rehearsal? At least 50. It's all about energy. It's all about kind of having fun and really pushing it forward. And it's also a really fun piece because I think we get to feature a lot of our soloists from throughout the orchestra, who you'll hear again and again throughout the night. And this piece for me is also kind of a call home for me because I actually got my start writing music for orchestra. And then I did a lot of other stuff, and now I'm kind of back. I've been writing a lot of orchestral music in the last year, year and a half. And when I mentioned the piece to Irv, he was just like, let's do it. This sounds like a good idea. And that just shows how great of a human Irv Wagner is. So without further ado, I present to you the world premiere of Periapsis.
Thank you. Hi, it's me again.
Thank you so much again for being here. And as I mentioned, this program, we aren't just featuring the finished product. We aren't just featuring the stuff that you normally think of when you think of young artists, because something that a lot of people don't think about is, well, a lot of young artists are conductors in training, and some of them even have degrees from this university, Oklahoma Christian. And one of those is actually one of our cellists, Lily, and she is a fabulous young conductor, and she also, again, she shows that part of conducting that you normally don't see, because you normally don't walk down the practice room hallways and hear someone practicing their baton flailing. At least I didn't whenever I was an undergrad. And I think it's really cool that we get to see that product here, as she magically imbues the flute during the Magic Flute Overture from Mozart.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm Janet Romanish. I'm chair of the Young Artist Competition. And this, I'm pleased to say this is our 17th annual. And this is a competition we have we've had for the past, well, we started in 2006. We missed 1 year because of COVID. This is for college students aged 17 to 25. And every year we've just been thrilled to have wonderful kids play with the orchestra. We have two overall winners who perform with the orchestra, but we have four divisions of competition. We have brass and percussion is one, strings, woodwinds, and piano. So this year I'd like to recognize our two division winners who are not performing. One is Dylan Halliday from OSU. He's a bass trombone player. And the other is Samuel Gillis, violinist from UCO. And I don't think they're here, but if they are, they could come up and get certificates. The division winners win $200, and the performers with the orchestra win $1,000 each. So I'll be back later to present the certificates and checks to our two performers today, who I'm sure you will really enjoy.
Hi, so I want to take a moment before we do this next piece just to give a really big shout out to the music director of this organization, of the Oklahoma Community Orchestra, Dr. Irvin Wagner. Can we get a round of applause for him? He really is a fabulous, legendary human, and we're just honored to work with him, and we're so happy with the program that he's put together, and now we're actually going to hear from one of his favorite composers of all time, the Hanson Serenade for flute, harp, and strings.
Thank you.
So I don't think that last one was a young composer situation, but it was decided to be included by Dr. Wagner because the piece is, well, that was a selection of tunes by John Williams, this little indie composer, you may have heard him, he's done one or two films. Anyways, so that piece, the reason why it was chosen is because, well, first of all, John Williams is John Williams, you can't not do that. But the other reason is he actually just turned 91 this year. And he actually wanted to do this exact suite last year, but there was something wrong with that. So anyways, we finally got to program it. And for me, anyone that knows me knows I am a huge Star Wars nerd. So I just had my dream come true here on stage. That was beautiful. In fact, I was very sad because I had an old lightsaber baton I was given, and turns out it has proprietary batteries that I did not have more of. So I didn't get to fully live out that. It's okay. Next time, folks, we'll do it next time with the lightsaber, I promise. So, another really great thing I think about including that on a program like this is because there's actually been a big push lately by composers all over the world, sorry, conductors all over the world, because some of the best music being written right now isn't just for the concert hall. A lot of it is actually written originally for film, television, video games, etc. And we're adapting it to concert halls. In fact, there are a couple of conductors, that have been looking to composers like John Williams and saying, this piece is just as good as the Brahms Requiem, or this is just as good as Mozart 40. I'm gonna program them alongside and just call it normal. And I think that's actually a really cool thing that's happening because we are seeing the canon be established right before our very eyes. And it's coming from a very unlikely place because it wasn't too long ago where you would have to see a pops only concert in order to see something like that played that well. And I think it's really great that we're starting to see that integration of pop and concert music come together in that way. So this next piece, before I go and fetch a pianist, there's probably a pianist outside somewhere that I need to get. But this next piece, I want to talk briefly about. This next piece is one that I guarantee it's the only other piece in the program that you've probably never heard of before. It is a piano concerto by a Polish composer that I honestly cannot pronounce her name to save the life of me, still to this moment. I keep trying, and it keeps getting worse and worse. But the great thing about this is you're actually going to hear this piece performed, and I think pretty gosh darn well, because we've got a great orchestra, and we've also got a lovely soloist who has been putting this together over the past months to make this work. And honestly, I think this has been a really rewarding experience for all of us, going through a piece of music that most of us have never even heard of, let alone played before. And I think you're gonna hear some awesome sounds that are going to be unforgettable, and I really hope you enjoy this, what I think is going to be a very unique experience for you with the piano soloist. I'm going to go outside and see if I can find one.
yeah, it's my great pleasure to give these two ladies a certificate and a check each. And we are so happy to have accompanied them today, and I gather that from what I heard in the audience, I think you enjoyed it too. Let's give them another hand.
Didn't they do great? Working with young artists, working with soloists in general, it's always really fun. It's a really rewarding experience. And it's also, it's such a collaborative effort because there's all sorts of things where, well, we're hopping in between duets between everyone. We're sitting there coordinating 14 things at once and we're trying to do our best to do it and keep you none the wiser. But this next piece, it's not really too much young artists related. This is actually something, I asked Irv, Dr. Wagner, about this. And I was like, so Dr. Wagner, this is young artists, like, make sense of the rest of it. You know, John Williams is awesome. And, you know, Mozart was technically kind of young whenever he wrote Magic Flute, only 34 or so. But why Bolero? And he was like, well, I wanted a way to feature all of our young artists, and I also wanted a way to feature the artists of the orchestra. For those that are unfamiliar with Bolero, basically, just about every instrument on this stage gets a moment to shine. And some of you get to shine on multiple instruments at once. I'm sorry. But no, it's quite a challenge from the beginning. It's also really rewarding. It's one of those pieces that a lot of people will groan about and they'll be like, oh, it's the same melody, but really the artistry comes from the colors that you hear within the piece, because you're gonna hear a single idea, but you're gonna hear it evolved and shaped and retextured over time. And you're going to be taken, hopefully, on a magical musical journey to bring this whole night to a close. And before we present that piece, I just want to do a few quick reminders. I just wanna make sure I haven't forgotten any of them. I wrote them down because, just ask anyone here, I'm very forgetful. So first of all, thank you, Janet, for presenting the young artist stuff. It's really important to do that. Second of all, I have been asked by Dr. Wagner to plug our May 21st concert. It's going to be a lot of pop stuff. We're going to have a former governor in here. We're going to be doing all sorts of fun stuff. There's going to be all sorts of fun instruments happening on stage. I've been told not to spoil too much other than to tell you it's going to be a great time. And that's going to be on Sunday, May 21st. I believe it's at like 3 p.m. or something like that. Check our website. It's always a good thing to double check. And then the final thing, I want to thank our hosts here at Oklahoma Christian. They have provided a wonderful space for us to rehearse and perform in. And also thank you to everyone that is working the show tonight, all of you showrunners, people backstage, out in the sound booth, all of that. You are all doing lovely. And then also I want to just thank our music director one more time, Dr. Irvin Wagner, for putting together incredible concert music and working with these musicians on a daily basis. Can we get one last round of applause for Irv Wagner? And then I also, on a personal note, I want to thank you all for coming out here. And I want to thank these musicians for putting up with me for the past few weeks. This wasn't the plan 2.5 weeks ago, I'll tell you that. But they've all been troopers, they've been putting up with me, and thank you for putting up with me in two capacities this time. And thank you all again for coming out. And without further ado, we're gonna take a couple of tuning notes, and then we will present Ravel's Bolero.
We'll be right back.